told you he was ready.
We travel once in a while. We have a little bad company, but we deal with it.
I can sit up and look over your shoulder. Let's listen in. Thank you.
Hold up your hands. We want your guns. Now hold on. We don't want any of that.
I'm unarmed. I don't want to fight.
Get to fighting or get going.
Well, that was the gunfight.
Yeah.
All the action over in about 30 seconds. I'm Wyatt Earp, and I'm the hero of this little bit of history. And believe it or not, I came through it without a scratch. My brother Morgan, he took a round across the back that hit both shoulder blades, probably from Billy Clanton's gun while he was down on the ground. He was assassinated several months later by a cowboy who shot him in the back while he was playing pool. No one was ever charged. My brother Virgil, he took a bullet to the leg and he survived, and he recovered from it fairly well, but 2 months after that he was ambushed by some cowboys and was maimed fairly bad and never really did recover. Even so, he worked in law enforcement for the railroads and several towns across the West. He finally died in 1905 from pneumonia while he was working with me in Nevada. Ike Clanton was the head of the cowboys. Even though he threatened us for a long time before the gunfight. When it came to slinging lead, he was conveniently unarmed and ran away. In 1887, he got accused of cattle rustling with his brother Phineas and was pursued by Detective Jones Brighton. When cornered, Phineas gave up. Ike decided to shoot it out and lost. Billy Claiborne was unarmed at the gunfight also. His reputation was ruined and he ended up moving away from the area. He did move back in 1882 after Doc and I had left, but he had heard that Billy the Kid, William Bonney, had died, was killed in 1881, and he insisted on being called Billy the Kid after that. He killed several men that disagreed with him. He tried the same tactic on a noted gunfighter named Frank Leslie, who bested him in a typical Western shootout. Frank McGlory took a bullet to the belly and one to the head, which killed him instantly. It was probably Doc's gun that got him. Now, Billy Clanton was 19 years old at the time of the gunfight. He got round through the right hand early in the gunfight and had to finish the gunfight shooting left-handed. He ended up with a round in the stomach and one in the chest, which did him in. In a gunfight, it's hard to tell where the shots are coming from and who shot who. This is Tom McLowery. He had 12 buckshot wounds to one side of his chest, which could have only come from Doc Holliday's scattergun. Now, Doc took a round across the hand. After the gunfight was over, Doc and I were both arrested and brought before Justice Spicer, who declared that there wasn't enough evidence to warrant a trial. We knew that the law was not going to take care of any of the attacks on our family, so Doc and I started a posse, which tracked down the cowboys, and we killed most of the people responsible for the damage to my family over the next several months. Doc and I parted ways in April 1882, and we never saw each other again. Tuberculosis finally took Doc in 1885 in November. As for myself, Josephine and I, Josephine and I followed the boom towns from Idaho to Alaska and back over the next 25 years or so. Everywhere I went, they wanted me to be a deputy, which I always agreed to. During our travels, I ran saloons, I dealt cards, and I even did a little bit of mining. I wasn't a saint. I wasn't a saint, but, you know, I still did all right. As a sporting man, I refereed over 30 prize fights and even did a consultation on some silent westerns for Hollywood. My time came in January 1929 at the age of 80. I was the last of the gunfighters of the OK Corral. An old cowboy went riding out. Yeah. Yeah.
No, it's not for you. Yeah, it's he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged sky. And with a cloudy draw, their brands were still on fire and their golden face appeared. Their clothes were black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of terror went through him as they thundered through the sky. His voice held wide, his coming wide.
Cheers, everybody. It's nice to meet you.
Their eyes are blurred, their shirts all soaked with sweat.
Now this is he's way, way, way long before Columbus has ever thought of. This is from like 2,000-4,000 years ago.
Get up and dance. Get in your pocket.